In this lecture, we will see where we can apply operations research and what are the different models one can have in operations research. First application is manufacturing. Operation research success in contemporary business pervades manufacturing and service operations. Logistics, distributions, transportation, and telecommunication. Operation research is used for various activities which include scheduling, routing, workflow improvements, elimination of bottleneck, inventory control, business process, re-engineering, site selection, or facility and general operational planning. OR helps in developing software for material flow analysis and design for flexible manufacturing facilities using pattern recognition and graph theory algorithms. Further, approaches for the design of reconfigurable manufacturing systems and progressive automation of discrete manufacturing system are under development. And this development continues from time to time, changes from time to time. Additional OR project focuses on the industry deployment of computer-based methods for assembly line balancing, business process engineering, capacity planning, pool scheduling, and setup reduction. But next area is revenue management. The application of OR in revenue management entails first to accurately for escalating the demand and secondly to adjust the price structure over time to more profitably allocate fixed capacity. Next is supply chain management. In this area, OR helps in taking decisions that include the who, what, when, and where. Abstractions from purchasing and transportation raw materials and parts through manufacturing actual products and goods, and finally distributing and delivering the item to the customer. The primary objective here is to reduce overall cost while processing customer orders more effectively and efficiently than before. That means over and again you are improving your supply chain management in terms of manufacturing, in terms of distributing, and at the end customer satisfaction. The power of utilizing OR methods allows examining a rather complex and convoluted chain in a comprehensive manner and to search among a vast number of combinations for the resource optimization and allocation strategy that seems more effective and hence beneficial to the operation. Next is retailing. In supermarkets, data from store loyalty card scheme is analyzed by OR group to advance our merchandising policies and profitability improvement. OR methods are also used to decide when and where new store development should be made. We know any new venture involves huge amount of investment. So in that case, OR can help us whether to have and where to have new store. Financial services. In financial markets, OR practitioners address issues such as portfolio and risk management and planning and analysis of customer service. There are widely employed in credit risk management, a vital area for lenders needing to ensure that they find the optimal balance of risk and revenue. OR techniques are also applied in cash flow analysis and capital budgeting. Marketing management. OR helps marketing manager in making the apt selection of product mix. It helps them in making optimal sales resource allocations and assignments. But for all these activities, we need to have a human. So human resource management comes in a picture. OR techniques are being applied widely in the functional area of human resource management by helping the human resource managers in activities like manpower planning, resource allocations, staffing and scheduling of training programs. General management. OR helps in designing decision support system and management of information systems, organizational design and control, software process management, and knowledge management. Once you have raw material and industry, then production system comes. The area of operation research that concentrates on real world operational problem is known as production system. Production system problems may arise in settings that include, but these are not limited to, manufacturing, telecommunication, healthcare delivery, facility location and layout, and staffing. Let us see what are the models which are well defined in operations research. Obviously, when a problem or process under investigation is simplified and represented with its typical features or characteristics is known as a model. A model can act as a substitute for representing reality, such as small scale model, locomotive, or may act as some sort of idealization like a model plan for recruitment process, etc. Constructing a model helps in bringing the complexity and possible uncertainties into a logical framework required for comprehensive analysis. In fact, the model acts as a vehicle in arriving at a well-structured view of reality. An array of models can be seen in various business areas or industrial activities. First comes physical models. To deal with specific types of problems, models like diagram, charts, graphs, and drawings are used, which are known as physical models. The schematic way of representation of significant factor and interrelationship may be in a pictorial form help in useful analysis. They help in easy observations, description, and predictions. However, they overrule any manipulation. There are two types of physical models. First one is iconic models. An image or likeness of an object or process is icon. These models represent the system as it is by scaling it up or down. It is used in the field of engineering and science. In the field of research and development, generally we call it R&D, prototype of the product is developed and tested to know the workability of the new product development. Photographs, portraits, drawings are the good example of iconic types. These models help in testifying the samples, thus avoiding full-scale designing and probable loss. So it reduces risk. Next is analogous models. These models are closely associated with iconic models. However, they are not the replicas of the system or process. The analog help in analyzing the issues and forces which are in the system or process. Next comes symbolic models. Symbolic models use letters, numbers, figures to represent decision variables of the system. There are two types of symbolic models: verbal model and mathematical models. Verbal models describe a situation in written or spoken language. Written sequences, books, etc. are examples of a verbal model. Mathematical model. Mathematical symbols are used to represent a problem or a system under these types of models. Rules of mathematics enable the builder to make the models more abstract and precise. There are two types of mathematical models: deterministic models and probabilistic models. Let us see what are deterministic models. The exact statement of variables and the relationships are made under these models. The coefficients used for the mathematical formulation are known and are constant with certainty. While probabilistic models are the risk involved and the state of uncertainty can be covered by these models. Here, the decision variables take the form of probability distribution and can you assume more than single values. In the presence of risk and uncertainty, these models tend to yield different answers every time, whenever attempts are made. For example, uncertainty over acquisition of raw material to rescue customer orders during a certain period. Here, rescue means execute. That is when you can satisfy the demand of the customer. The purchaser has to consider both the sell and the delivery timings of orders as they are variables. A probability distribution can be developed for the instant period for both sales and delivery timings. The optimum selection is adhered to in accordance with the demand of the situation. Third comes combined analog and mathematical models. When analog models are interpreted with the use of mathematical symbols, they can be termed as physical symbolic models. Next comes functional models. Models which are used to represent a group of function performance are called function models. If everything fails which are said above, then heuristic models comes into picture. When intuition guides a problem solver to find solution, heuristic models are developed. Even though he would not be able to find an optimal solution to the problem, with his past experience, he arrives at the most advantageous solution.